a new setting for the bike, and in a daft kind of way, we'd been like a sort of dry session behind the whole weekend, and morning warm-ups being dry this morning, we got a chance to try what we wanted to try, and the bike worked really, really well. So we knew we had good longevity because we did warm-up on used tyres, and we knew we had a half-decent pace, but, you know, I got to the front, and every time I got like plus 0.5 on my board, I thought, right, just concentrate, try and break them. And then the next lap I'd come around, I think I'd gone really fast and it'd be back to plus zero again. And I'd be thinking, God, give me a break, you know, just a second or something like that to actually relax and get into a bit of a rhythm. But it was screen chewing all the way around and 30 long laps. But fortunately, we managed to stay in the front.
It's a typical track knockout. It's one of them circuits that you're riding hard, but it's how you as a rider, your style and the bike's working. You know, it tends to be sort of elastic band effects around this track, cat and mouse. And yeah, I knew we had the pace, you know, from this morning, the warm-up session, went out and used tyres and was shaking, and felt good. But, you know, I wanted to make a lunge, but every time I found myself in a position to make a move, I was coming from so far back, and I was tempted a few times, but I think we would have probably both ended up in a heap at the hairpin. But yeah, we'll have a look at race two and make a few changes to the bike as well, I think, in certain areas. But in all, the package is working well. As you can see, you know, when I dropped off shaky, I lost the front a few times and then dropped off shaky. And then once I could do my own thing and ride my own lines, I pulled him straight back in again and set the quickest lap of the race. So we've got the pace, we've got the bike. It's just typical when you're in a position to try and make a move, you're too far back because shaky and his bike might be working better in other areas. But we've done a good job. We can't sort of grumble about that. I think we're leading the championship now, but I'm not paying too much attention on the championship at this time. It's a matter of just keep getting podium points and keep pushing and try to get one step higher in race two.
And we made a change and thought we hadn't gone in the right direction, so we went back to yesterday's settings, and actually in that race I was losing the front a little bit. There was a couple of areas, same idea as Tommy really. He was stronger in some areas than I was, and the same shaky, his bike was working better in other areas, so it was a little bit of an accordion effect. You know, they would gap me in some areas and I would come back on them, but overall in the lap, our lap times were so similar and it was hard to make any passes because we're lapping so close. So I could have had a sniff at Tommy at the end there, but we probably would have ended up colliding, so I thought better of it. But yeah, I think we can improve the bike a little bit for race two and try and push on a little bit harder. There was just a couple of little areas where I was struggling, but yeah, fair play to both Tommy and Shaky. They didn't make a single mistake, and yeah, it ended up being a boring race, no passes at the end. So hopefully race two we can put on a good fight between the three of us, but yeah, it's going to be close.